This is the reading of 10th class. It is a folk tale. It was a dark night. There was a heavy downpour. An old tiger ran through the rain looking for a shelter. Then it heard a woman's voice complaining about a leak, which she expressed terrible. The tiger did not know what was that leak and thought it might be a stronger creature. Thinking like that, it fell asleep. Suddenly, it felt some heavy blows on its shoulders, and also a screaming voice shouted at him and called it as a horrible beast. The old tiger shivered and thought that must be the leak. So it obeyed the creature and allowed to be bound around the neck with a thick rope. So the mysterious creature climbed onto the tiger's back and pulled it at the rope. The tiger felt kicks, blows, and it was goaded towards a house where it was tied to a tree. Actually, what happened before that, let us see now. Okay, so here the tiger was tied by a creature. Okay, who is that creature and where it was tied, let us see now. Okay, on the afternoon of that day, a potter came home after tedious work and drank some palm wine to relax. Then the storm started and he thought of his donkey. So he went out to take the donkey to the stable, but he could not find it except a chain of it. Then he grumbled and started searching in the heavy rain. He stumbled over the bushes and plants in the marshy area. He became wild. In search of it, he reached the old woman's hut. The drunken potter did not notice the difference between the donkey and tiger. So he brought it and tied in front of his house. The next morning, villagers came and amazed. They thanked him as the tiger was killing their cattle. After seeing that, the potter fainted. A few years later, a war broke out between the strong neighboring king and the potter's country. The king came to know about the brave potter and installed him as chief in army. He was allotted a palace. The potter did not know even climbing a horse. He was intense. The very next morning, he had to go to the battle. His wife was a clever woman. She tied the legs and hands of the potter very tightly to the back of the horse. The horse started running. He was not able to control it. He decided to jump from it. So he caught a young tree. The tree was uprooted because of the force of horse while running. One of the soldiers or the sentry of the enemy camp, happened to see the potter with the uprooted tree. He ran and informed their king. Immediately, they vacated the camp by keeping a letter. He went back and gave the letter to his wife. The king rewarded the potter. Everyone thought that the potter was humble as he went to the king's court on foot. Except his wife, nobody knows that the potter was a timid fellow. Okay, this is the brave potter. Now let us discuss the question and answers. First question is, what did the tiger think the mysterious creature was? Why did he allow himself bound around the neck with a thick rope? First one is, what did the tiger think the mysterious creature was? Actually, the tiger thought that the mysterious creature was the leak, because the woman has told that that is terrible. The leak was terrible. So it thought that though it was the king of the forest, it thought that something must be there, and that is more stronger than it itself. That's why it thought that the mysterious creature was nothing but the leak. Why did he allow himself bound around the neck with a thick rope? Because it thought that if it would not allow himself bound around the neck, then that would be killed by the creature, the mysterious creature. That was nothing but the leak. So it obeyed whatever the mysterious creature has guided. Okay. Then what made the potter angry? Because the potter already drunken, and that fellow has missed his donkey. And he was in search of the donkey, and when he was searching that through the forest, he stumbled because of the marshy area and also the herbs and shrubs, small plants, everything was there. So he stumbled over the marshy area. That's why he got more angrier, because he could not get the donkey. Okay, so he got anger. Then why did the king make the potter the general of the army? Because the king came to know that this Potter was the brave one from one of his ministers, because he came to know that this Potter tied the tiger in front of his house to a tree. So he thought like that, and immediately he called the Potter and made him the general of the army. Then why do you think that the sentry feels that the Potter is a giant? Because the Potter, his intention was of course somewhat different, but he came on the horse with a uprooted tree. Okay, one hand the tree which was uprooted, and the other hand the reins of the horse. So the sentry thought that he must be the giant Potter. Okay, then he immediately went to the camp and informed the king. Do you think the Potter is really brave or lucky? We know that he is not really brave, but he is very lucky because the situation has helped him to overcome the adversity. Okay, so like that he is really brave, but he is not really brave, but he is lucky. Okay, so like this you can develop the answers and make a note in your notebooks. Thank you.